I'm very happy to be here today. It's a great honor to talk at the Hong Kong Business Design Week. And I want to specially thank the organizer for this first invitation to introduce Wuhao in Hong Kong. It's also something very special to me, because 3 years before, in December 2009, I was like you in the audience, in the same exact program. At this time, Wuhao was an idea, a concept, and what I can call my Chinese dream. I was ready to start, inspired by this sentence of Goethe, which says that whatever you can, begin it. Boldness has genius, power, and magic on it. I was ready to transform my personal adventure in China in a collective adventure and in a business. 3 years later, I'm here again, on stage this time, to explain how I met this happened and to share with you the experience I built on the way, especially on Chinese fashion industry. Preparing this talk, I asked myself, how can I talk about a reality turning business? How can I talk about fashion when fashion is just one small part of my daily activity? This sounds challenging. My first thought as an entrepreneur in China was to prepare a list of our achievements. All the things I'm very proud after these 3 years in China. Wuhao, Curated-shop, created in June 2010 in Beijing to foster and showcase the most talented and eco-conscious designer from China and abroad, has now 2 years existence. You know how it is in China. You have plans for China, and China have plans for you, and never the same. We have to be prepared for permanent changes and adjustments. You think you are creating a new kind of select shop. Select shop is not new. I've collected in Paris, Corso Como in Milan, Dover Street Market in London. But you had nothing in Beijing, so I decided to be one of them. And then, day after day, you discover that you are just in the process of creating a unique channel to release the fabulous Chinese energy. A unique platform for design. This is what China allows in 2 years. We went through 4 different activities. We set up shop, pop-up shop. We created events for us, for others. We conduct cross-branding operation, and we launched 8 limited editions. We participated 2 times on the Beijing Design Week. We are working with a growing network of 100 designers. We won awards. We went to Milan, London, and Paris. We initiated partnerships, tea, motor tours, and we had an amazing media coverage to talk about. Is it Wuhao? I'm not sure. One of my guests told me few weeks before, Isabelle, you are not allowed to keep this story for you alone. Please, share it. Tell the story. I suddenly realized that it's exactly what I proposed to my guests. After this lost and found game in the Hutong, the small Beijing alley, I give them a cup of tea and I propose. I propose to listen to a space, to listen to a product, to listen to an energy, to listen to the story behind the product, to listen to the story of the people who create this product. And I just let them film what sometimes we can't understand. And I want to let them buy, let them be a part of the story. The stories, it what make us unique. And it starts like a real story. 5 elements philosophy, maybe you have heard about. The Chinese, 3,000 years before, invented this. Roots of Chinese culture, a system which infuses all dimensions of what we call today the lifestyle. I discovered this impressive combinatorial system in which the entire natural world is classified and ordered into a system of 5. When my Chinese friend asked me how I master all of these topics, I just answered by looking at you. As it was said, I came to China for 6 months, and I am there for 5 years now. These five elements are something that Chinese use daily, most of the time, without realizing it. These five elements, everything starts in wood, spring, emerging vision on the east. Then the things continued on the south with fire, summer, hurt. Then comes fall, sharp, white, metal in the west. And then a black, blue, deep water, winter in the north. In the center, vibrant yellow, earth. Taste, think, focus, the five seasons, the fifth seasons. 18 days each season where you center yourself, keep the best to reinvest in the new, and to link everything, a lot of interrelationship. A fabulous creation generator. Holistic, organic, connected with the past, open to the future, a perfect marketing concept. Then, Wuhao was created. Five is the number for function, the perfect framework for design. Five is also a crossroad, one center and four direction. A natural movement, a breath, yeah. I created Wuhao like this, from the four direction to central Beijing, from central Beijing to the four direction. I welcome there talents, designers, guests, clients. I spread out projects, insights, energy, freshness. Thank you very much. Welcome and spread out. Two keywords, our beautiful daily routine. We are mobile, from one place to the other, from one season to the other. We are curious, season after season. We follow the natural cycle and the Chinese speed. We are part of this continuous process where new excitements are coming soon, providing our clients ever-changing installation and display. New designer, new product, trends, fashion, a kind of what some people call retail entertainment. This gave 10 eye-catching installations in 2 years. Every season, we invite a bunch of shop curators, creative talents, to work with us and create a new playground. I give them space. I give them time, sometimes both. Each time, all together, we committed ourselves to create something that fights the stereotypes. No creativity, no taste, and that only the French have mastered luxury, especially French women. I don't think so. A touch, a flair maybe, nothing more, nothing less. We are purposely confidential, far from the easy way. I created Wuhao downtown as a destination place with no window, no more location, no lead to immediate purchase. All my friends when I created Wuhao, especially my Chinese friends, say, are you crazy, lost in the Hutong with no window, and how can your clients can come to you? They come. Because what we are doing is just make all together a place where we invite people to walk in the yard, to meditate, to share a dinner, to pause, lay down, preserve, be eco-aware. We make them try, touch, taste, feel, listen, smell. We help them to enjoy design and fashion as a part of lifestyle. We make them pause. The clients and the talents. We make them think about this second Chinese time, the one when you need to take time. We take time. We take the time to build a collection. In 2 years, with young designers graduated from the most prestigious school in China, we created furniture, jewelry, and soon fashion. Another way to turn the dream and drawings into reality, and a lot of opportunities to go further. We worked with craftsmen, we thought about mobility and new lifestyle behavior with Zhang Cheng, we thought about nature and outdoor space with Zheng Haicheng, We talk about harmony with Xiao Tianyu. We thought about the traces we let with Wuhao. We reinvented the tea ceremony with Hui Jin and the Dun Huang patterns with Ni Ku. Xiao Tianyu here, the image has the best way. Zhang Cheng, Wuhao, Su Chunrong, Wang Kaichuang, Zheng Haicheng, Hui Jin, and the wallpaper we created with Ni Ku. And the last one, the last and third, the number 8, very important, Wu Mian, the young designers with who we build the earth. To greenhouse all this creativity, at the moment, two space, one Chinese garden and one tea house. Some invitations, some destinations, a little bit of what Chinese call yuan fen, and a lot of link with our close environment. The first one, Wuhao base, in the heart of Beijing, a peaceful place in the bustling Hohai area, an historical garden, and a beautiful encounter. From Mauer, sometimes we escape. We went in 2011 for the Beijing Design Week, another Design Week, in Zujia Hutong. There, we set up in 3 weeks a temporary tea house in Dashalar, a vivid neighborhood, small shops, and a bunch of loafing tourists. These two places are both atmospherical, deeply Chinese, completely contemporary, invested by young designers. Once again, we let the existing inspire the next. So here, I just want to show you a video, short video of the tea house, and to show you how we make it happen. Okay, so I'm sorry you can't. It's impossible to see us there anymore because this was a temporary project, but our permanent space in Mauer Hutong is still there. So, Mauer Hutong, Zhujia Hutong, two chances to reinvent the space and to create a lot of emotions. Inside the space, a lot of things, an intuitive combination, products and furniture design, accessories, homeware, fashion. Through the cup you will drink in, the chair you will sit on, the perfume you will smell, the tea you will taste, the table you will eat on, the clothes you will try on, you will get an experience which makes sense. And we try mixing green, people, contemporary artisan, tradition, and trends and heritage. Fashion, yeah, we are here this afternoon to talk about fashion. I don't forget. Fashion, what does it mean in the Wuhao context? Does it mean that everybody should wear green in spring and red in summer? Of course not. To me, fashion is not just a catwalk story or hunger story. Fashion is trends, but not only. Sometimes it's temporary, sometimes it's permanent, sometimes it's atemporal. Fashion, for sure, for me, is diversity. Fashion can be exclusive or can be serie. But fashion is a daily choice. Fashion is a daily commitment. Today, what to wear? Who to be? Fashion is selection, an exclusive selection. From kidswear to menswear to womenswear, we have everything at Wuhao. But most of the time, the people, they ask me, how do you select? I think I just revealed half of my process during these past 10 minutes. The other half, I'm here in Hong Kong, like everywhere in the world, constantly looking, meeting, touching, and asking. I want to know who, what, when, how, why. And when I find something beautiful, interesting, innovative, unique, with potential, I select with my eyes and with my heart, my intuition, and my care for the people I will welcome. And then it's a question of nice encounters, unexpected coincidence, inspiring trip. I let myself go with the energies, the seasons. Of course, I have all the time Wuhao concept in my mind, but I combine, I team up, I choose what draws me out, make me curious, will bring something different, and what we call in French this supplément d'âme. Select fashion is the most complicated. It needs sharp eyes, especially in China, where the young Chinese designers at the moment have their own rhythm. They don't follow the schedule of the fashion week or the traditional spring, summer, fall, winter resort pattern. They are freestyle. Most of them are very young, less than 25 years old. They create their own studio when nobody wants to produce in small quantity. They invent fabrics when they can't find the one they want. They suddenly refuse to use a fabric or techniques because of eco-consciousness. I remember these young designers who said, "Isa, I'm sorry, I won't use silk again because I don't want to kill worms anymore." We are in China, silk, you don't want to use silk. So let's innovate, let's find some intelligent textile, or let's try a way to don't kill worms. We are working on these directions. These people are fresh. And while they dream of a career a la Alexander Wang, they want to do it their own way. Sometimes they create just pieces for the show. It's not an easy job every day, especially as a buyer, because when you want to pair them with international designer who propose their collection 1 year in advance, it's quite difficult. But all the time, it's exciting and unexpected. And it's a kind of very transformative experience. At Wuhao, we follow those designers. We buy interesting pieces and find for them the clients. We guide them. We help them to improve. We don't want them as good Chinese designer. I want them as good designer in modern China. I want them to be able to compete everywhere in the world. Most of them go abroad. They complete their studies at Central Saint Martin's, FIT, Parsons School, and then they come back. Even if I have no doubt that the European and the US houses where they are interning would love to keep them. But they come back, and faithful to our mission of hunting talents, we give to them a space to come back, to grow, and to meet their markets. Because I think fashion is also an invitation, a series of invitations. At Wuhao, it goes both ways. We are invited, we invite, we commission, we provoke imagination. We go beyond the one shot. We push new ideas, inviting foreign designers to join. We talk about intelligent textile, green awareness. We play with all the topics. I will just give you here, for example, four seasons, for example. The first one is Yang Xiaojin. I met Yang Xiaojin in winter 2010. She came to show me her knitting collection. Looking at her drawings and sample, I was attracted by a special technique of embroidery made with bamboo and silk thread. I asked to see more, and I was caught. I commissioned Yang Xiaojun in spring 2011. I gave her the spring keywords, green, east, fresh, new, and she came back with this dress, which is made by traditional techniques embroidery on recycled plastic bags. This happened and finds its natural setting in our garden. Now it's winter, and Yang Xiaojun went back to knittings. But this was a quite interesting experience. In summer, the story starts as a joke with the comment of one of our best friends. One of our friends one day said, "Don't be annoyed, Isa, but I think you have the most amazing souvenir shop in Beijing." This idea stays stuck in my mind. Beijing souvenir. When I discovered this summer this irresistible Chinese-inspired funny design collection of vase and postcard dress by Grand Zero, a Hong Kong label, and when I met Philippe Xu, wife of the designer of Grand Zero, also graduated from Central Saint Martins, I say, "Philippe, we have to do something together. Let's do a Beijing souvenir dress." And this was made in May 2012, we launched a scarf and a dress with a postcard. And on this postcard, there is the souvenir of Wuhao in spring, where in spring I invited the British designer, Christopher Rayburn, to join us. And he made on the stone landscape that we have in the middle of our place, a green squirrel made by inflatable parachute. And then Philippe Xu integrated in the postcard dress this special artwork. It was one way more for me to join these two designers, one who studied in Central Martin School, the other one who is from London, and all together do something for Wuhao. The third designer is He Yan. It was another story, fall 2011. Oh, wow, it seems that, okay. So He Yan is a Mingguo style collection. I talk more, I am very chatty. And especially when I talk about all these young people who have so many things to tell. So He Yan made a Mingguo inspired dress for us, past inspired, contemporary born. Another example is Yang Du, also Central Saint Martins graduated, and the superhero dress. You know, everybody thinks that, of course I'm French, so I need to have something special with black dress. All my Chinese friends and my Chinese clients say, "You are French, you need to provide us black dress." So I started the story with Didier Ludo 2 years before, and I continued now with Asian designers, because I think that the black dress is something so universal. And so now we have black dress by Plots, another Hong Kong label, and by new Japanese, and et cetera, et cetera. We are all, I think, we all have in ourselves Audrey in Breakfast at Tiffany. So what about Earth? Earth is just a question of attitude, and I think is what I want to share with you. Fashion is something, it's not a panoply. It's not something that you understand maybe, but it's something that you feel. It's an attitude, as we say in French. So what will happen tomorrow? Now I have zero, so I have to finish. Tomorrow it will be winter, so flying birds in the winter sky. 5 plus 1, 6, maybe. 6 is another very, very interesting number. Here, abroad, I'm sure it will be multi-senses, multi-dimensions, and multi-direction. And I'm sure it will be, again, a full sensory experience. I just ask you to follow us now online. The next story is on the way. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Isabelle. Beijing is so lucky to have you.
Thank you very much.
All right, we have 5 minutes for questions from the floor, please.
Hi, nice to meet you. And I have some questions to ask you. And do you have the plan to expand your concept gallery in other Chinese cities? If yes, where and why? And how about Hong Kong? Do you think Hong Kong has the luxury to have your gallery here?
Okay, so expand, yes. The project I told you is one center and four directions. So I created Wuhao as the first base. But in my project, of course, should have Wuhao on the four direction in China. So we think about Chengdu, Hangzhou, or other cities in different parts of China. And to answer about Hong Kong, why not? Because I think Hong Kong, we are working at the moment with a lot of Chinese designers that we bring to mainland. So this is quite interesting. So why not thinking about Hong Kong? But if we open something in Hong Kong, it will be again like exactly what I did in Beijing or what I did in Dashlar, and there's two different spaces. First, I will have to feel and to listen to Hong Kong to find the right way to make it happen.
Thank you. Have you been to your HADI?
Yeah.
Okay. Let us know if you have that feel. Right, next question, please.
刚才有听到你说我是来自成都，是成都的画廊。然后我觉得你这个项目其实很好，不知道你知道成都的宽窄巷子吗？如果我觉得这个项目，你说你对成都很感兴趣，我不知道你只是一个刚才对于这个问题的一个回答，只是提到成都而已，还是你有这个商业的运作或者已经有开始？谢谢。
I mentioned Chengdu and Hangzhou, why? Because I think it's two cities in China where there is a very interesting lifestyle. And then why not bringing design? Design for me is part of life and lifestyle. What's this word that now we are all talking about? So why not there's two cities? And I think there are interesting cities with a lot of potential.
Hello, Isabelle. I'm a student from HKDI, studying fashion business. I have a few questions I want to ask you. So do you have your own concept gallery in your own country, like France?
No. I came here to do it. I think it's more complicated to open this kind of space in Europe or in the US at the moment. In China, it's not easy, but it's possible. And this is an amazing reservoir of ideas and young talents here. And my idea was really not to bring my own culture and my own country to China, but it was really to go from China to the rest of the world. Because most of the time, as a foreigner, I want to fight against all the stereotypes that I heard about China, that I told during the talk, there is no quality, no creativity, and no taste in China. This is completely not true. And this is why I created Wuhao, just to show to Chinese first, and to all the foreigners who travel to China, who can discover Wuhao everywhere now, that there is something amazing here, and that I want to be part of this.
So you're definitely here to stay. Oh, fantastic. All right, I think that's all the time we have for now. Thank you, Isabelle.
Thank you.
Thank you very much.